Hello, welcome to the video tutorial on how to create a WireGuard VPN server on OPNsense Firewall. WireGuard helps you create a fast and secure virtual private network. By default, WireGuard is not installed on OPNsense, so you must install it. On OPNsense, access firmware and install WireGuard plugins. I was required to update my firewall operating system before installing WireGuard. So I updated the latest version of OPNsense before installing plugins. After completing the OS update, I installed WireGuard plugins. WireGuard has been completely installed on OPNsense. Go to the VPN menu to start configuring the WireGuard server. You name and create a public key and create a private key for the WireGuard server. WireGuard listens to port 51820 by default, although you can change the default port if you want. Next, I created a subnet for the WireGuard VPN connections. You make sure this subnet is different from the subnet you use for your internal network. I have completed the WireGuard server configuration. Next, I create pairs for remotely connected devices. For example, I create a client configuration file for a Windows computer as above. The Windows computer connects to the firewall through the internet and it can access resources on my internal network. I set up an IP address for the WireGuard client and set up allowing that IP address on OPNsense. On the client configuration file, I set up the public key generated on the WireGuard server on the OPNsense firewall that was created in the previous step. Similarly, on OPNsense, you set up the generated public key on the client configuration file. The WireGuard VPN server listens to port 51820, so you set the port on the client configuration file. Windows computer makes a VPN connection to the OPNsense firewall over the internet using the public IP address on the WAN interface. As I introduced how to create configuration files, I started creating it. After completing the setup of the WireGuard interface on the client, I set up the peer. Here is the information set up on OPNsense. I allow all IP addresses. Next, set up the WAN IP address and port. This is the public address on the OPNsense firewall that helps you connect over the internet. I use WireGuard's default port 51820. If you use a dynamic public IP address, I will guide you through using the dynamic domain name service in the next part of the video. So I'm done creating the client configuration file. You export it and send it to your client Windows computer. But before connecting from the client Windows computer, you set up here on the OPNsense firewall as follows. In the WireGuard configuration on OPNsense, you add a new peer. Here you set up information corresponding to the client configuration file you just created. It helps you establish a handshake between the OPNsense firewall and the Windows computer. You copy the public key from the client configuration and paste it here. Then you allow the IP address that was set up in the previous step. I set up instances as WireGuard. WireGuard is the name of the instances I created in the previous step. By default, WireGuard is disabled, so don't forget to enable it. In addition to the default LAN and WAN interfaces, I added a new interface. This is the WireGuard interface for the virtual private network. By default, this interface is disabled, so don't forget to enable it. Next, you create rules on the WireGuard firewall to access remote resources. You go to the firewall and create a new rule on the WAN interface. As I mentioned in the previous step, WireGuard uses port 51820. So I set up a firewall that allows this port to pass through the OPNsense firewall on the WAN interface. I allow port 51820 to use the UDP protocol to pass through the firewall's WAN IP address. Thus, the Windows client computer can connect to the WireGuard server via OPNsense S1 interface. I should use both IP version 4 and IP version 6 for this rule. But the above rule does not allow remote access to local resources. So I created a new rule that helps WireGuard subnets access subnets. I create a new rule as follows. This rule is set on the WireGuard interface just created in the previous step. This rule applies to WireGuard subnets. I allow WireGuard to connect to any other subnet. Thus, the client computer can access resources in the internal network via the Internet. I recommend that you set the packet size to avoid errors when connecting to WireGuard. Instead of using packet 1500, set packet to 1360. Apply to WireGuard group. The default packet may be too large when transmitted over the WireGuard connection and cause errors. So you set up smaller packets when transmitting using WireGuard. Above are the basic settings to create a WireGuard VPN server. Next, I will check the results from a Windows computer separate from OPNsense by the Internet. First, I export the client configuration file created in the previous step and send it to the client Windows computer. You can use many different ways such as email, external drive, social network messages. But I recommend you keep it safe so that someone can access your internal network resources. On the client Windows computer, after installing the WireGuard application, I imported the configuration file obtained in the previous step and established the VPN connection. Even though this Windows computer is separated from OPNsense by the Internet, through the WireGuard connection I can access local network resources. You just need to follow the steps above to create a WireGuard VPN server on OPNsense. Next, I show you how to use a dynamic domain name service to solve the problem of public IP addresses changing. In the previous part of the video, I used a public IP address to establish a VPN connection. For this part, I use a free domain name and map it to a public IP address. On OPNsense, I installed a plugin called DDNS Client. It helps me set up various dynamic domain name services. After completing the installation, I went to the dynamic domain service on OPNsense. You select DNS from the drop-down list. Among dynamic domain name services, I use DNS. The reason is simple because it's free. Next, you just need to set up the token and domain name to complete. This is my token and domain name. I apply the changes and check the IP address assigned to my domain. A new public IP address has been assigned to my domain. Now I use this domain for WireGuard VPN connection. So I have solved the problem of public IP addresses changing over time. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck. In the WireGuard client, I change the configuration file as follows. I replace the public IP address with the domain name. Then save the changes and check the results. As you can see, the connection is successful. Similarly, you create more client configuration files if you have many different devices. With WireGuard, you can install on Android, iOS or Linux.